There are three types of lies: lies, damn lies, and statistics. This is perhaps the most famous quote about the branch of mathematics dealing with collection, analysis, interpretation, and presentation of masses of numerative data, also known as statistics. This quote is sometimes wrongly attributed to the American writer Mark Twain, but it actually comes from the father of modern British Conservative Party, Benjamin Disraeli. Statistics has always been a useful tool in politics to help understand the world around us, and even the etymology of the word statistics hints at its original purpose to be used by governmental and administrative bodies. But the quote also explains a sense of mistrust toward the science, because the persuasive power of numbers and, of course, figures can be used for wrong purposes or to strengthen weak arguments. Another quote says, "Facts are stubborn things, but statistics are pliable." That was really from Mark Twain. Nevertheless, our modern world is overwhelmed by quantitative data, and there's really no business sector that doesn't make enormous use of statistics. And agriculture is no different. Think about it. Agriculture is the result of many physical, social, cultural, economic, institutional, technological, political, and psychological aspects interacting with each other. And statistics can help policymakers, as well as stakeholders, the public opinion, journalists, having a better grasp of this complexity. The utility of figures about farming becomes clear either when numbers relate to purely economic aspects, such as the agriculture output or prices of agricultural commodities, or when data involve socio-economical features. For instance, what percentage of the population is involved in agriculture, which is useful to understand the trend of the population of rural areas. And we've recently seen new emerging environmental aspects that need some statistics to be assessed, like the impact of climate change and extreme weather conditions on farmers' ability to survive and build a profitable business, but also other environmental issues like soil quality, since soil organic matter has been increasingly depleted due to the land use intensification and monocultures. Data and numerical information have played a crucial role in the growth and development of agriculture. And the importance of statistical science was obvious even to European founding fathers, so that when in 1958 the original European community was set up, the forerunner of the modern Eurostat was also established. And again, the first publication that the then Statistical Office of the European Communities issued was on, guess what? That's right, agricultural statistics. Even today, Eurostat provides an incredible number of updated figures, tables, and charts in its database, which is available online and accessible free of charge by me, you, everyone. When the Common Agricultural Policy first saw the light of day in 1962, it was already clear that it would have had a big impact on the development of agricultural statistics in Europe. And that's because the implementation of the CAP requires statistics that were not only detailed and up-to-date, but also comparable in each member state. So the initial work was focused on the collection and harmonization of existing statistics in order to monitor the Common Agricultural Policy development. But over the past years, the focus has been partially moved on new emerging themes such as the environment and rural development. The Common Monitoring and Evaluation Framework for the past CAP program, which lasted from 2014 to 2020, identified a set of performance indicators that contribute to the assessment of CAP performance, such as farming income support, market orientation, and environment. On the Commission's website, you can find 12 thematic indicators and 45 context indicators. And again, this is available on the Commission's website free of charge. The thematic indicators basically combine normal statistics with further information, such as on trade and quality schemes. So, for instance, if we click on soil quality, which is, as I mentioned before, a top priority for European agriculture, you can find figures on things like crop diversity on EU farms, but also on the share of EU funding beneficiaries subject to crop diversification as the so-called greening measures in the past CAP program. And at the same time, you can find insightful figures on market orientation in the EU, such as the world price volatility for certain commodity. You can select beef, eggs, sugar, and so on. But also, when it comes to social economical aspects, there are interesting graphs like the share of direct support in agricultural income per country, which in a sense can tell us a bit more on the farmer dependence on EU subsidies for each member state. With the latest update of December 2020, there are also 45 new dashboards on context indicators, which are grouped into socioeconomic indicators, sectoral indicators, and environmental indicators. So, for example, we can check the livestock units, which is a tricky issue in the debate on the European Green Deal, and if you're interested, you can play with all of these numbers on the website. So, statistics are, of course, useful, helping both to forge public policies and for us to better assess them, but to close with another saying by George Bernard Shaw, statistics show that of those who contract the habit of eating, very few survive.